Daddy, do you love Jesus? Asked the little girl to the father. The father was extremely an irreligious man, condemning all religious practices. He replied, Jesus is dead, my dear, long, long ago. He was crucified and that was the end of him. The innocent child continued, but Jesus rose again and did what no man could do. And if Jesus is not living now, we could not be living either. He gives us life and everything else, Dad. The father questioned back, but how can I love whom I've never seen, my child? The little child didn't know what to reply. The father was extremely happy that his question puzzled the daughter. The little child put forth another question. Dad, how old was I when mommy died? 6 months old, my child, replied the father. The child said, can I say that I have never seen her, for I don't remember her at all? But you have been telling me how good and kind she was. I don't remember her of having seen her. I still do love her, Dad. With tears, he kissed the child and said, God has spoken to me by you. I realize I do need to love God even though I have never seen him. And you must pray for me, that God may give me a new heart with which I shall love Jesus. Easter faith calls us to the centrality of our lives in the Redeemer, who brings us hope and brings us back to a sense of witnessing. Christian life calls us to profess and proclaim the Lord by word and deed, through happy moments and struggles of life. It's good to reflect on the aspects of life, whereby we examine how much we acknowledge the Lord in our life. The first aspect, the blessings of God. God has gifted each one of us with immense graces and blessings. Do we acknowledge the blessings of the Lord in our life with a word of thanks and gratitude every day? The second aspect, the providence of God. Providence refers to the protective care of God at all moments, in every situation. When we look back, we see how God constantly leads us. True, there are times when we have felt the absence of God, or He is distant from us, especially in situations of struggles and suffering. When we look back, we find out that God had been joining the dots of loneliness into a beautiful picture. So do we acknowledge the providence of God in our life by being optimistic? Knowing that our God will not allow us to fall into extreme worry or anxiety. Instead, through His caring heart, He will hold us tenderly in His arms. The third aspect, the love and mercy of God. We have been created in love and we have been initiated to salvation by His mercy. We have been constantly encouraged by His love and continually lifted by His mercy. Do we acknowledge the love and mercy of God in our life? By seeking to always do His will in our life and letting go of our ego and selfish desires. The fourth aspect, the presence of God. The presence of God surrounds and encompasses at all moments in every step of our life. The presence of God is cherished and celebrated in the sacraments. Do we acknowledge the presence of God in our life by turning our hearts in conscious awareness to the presence of God in the midst of our work and activities? Do we have a longing for God. As a Christian, it's not so easy to profess and proclaim. But God invites each one of us gently and tenderly to acknowledge Him in our life. How God gives us the courage and the joy to proclaim Him to others and bring others to experience the love of Christ. We are called to pray and reflect on the centrality of our lives, which brings hope and brings us back to a sense of witnessing. I wish each one of you a happy Easter.